Hello, everybody. In the 21st century, our nations are connected like never before. In our global economy, our prosperity is shared. That's why, as president, I've committed the United States to a new era of engagement with the world, including economic partnerships that create jobs and opportunity for all our citizens. It's part of our larger effort to renew American leadership. And I thank Secretary Clinton and all of you for making economic statecraft a pillar of American diplomacy. Because just as we have to harness our economic strengths to advance American leadership in the world, we need to harness our foreign policy to advance our prosperity here at home. With your help, we're making progress towards the goal I set 2 years ago, doubling U.S. exports over 5 years so that more people around the world are buying products stamped with those three proud words, Made in America. We're moving ahead with trade pacts from South Korea to Colombia to Panama, increasing trade with emerging economies from Brazil to Turkey, from South Africa to India. And we're standing up to ensure that everybody plays by the same rules so that our companies can compete on a level playing field. Today, I'm proud to say that our exports have surged to record levels, supporting nearly 10 million American jobs. That's the progress we've made, the momentum that we have to sustain. And this is a two-way street. Even as we keep opening foreign markets to American goods, we want more foreign companies investing in America. So we're working to make it easier for companies to insource, to set up shop here in the United States. We're making it easier for tourists to get visas and visit America. We want the world to know America is open for business. So thank you. In capitals and countries in every corner of the world, you're the people behind this progress. You're the folks who bring our countries closer together every day. And I'm confident that working together will continue to forge the partnerships that create the jobs, the opportunity, and the dignity that our people deserve.